What are we doing to help refugees avoid coronavirus? Refugee camps and urban slums can be overcrowded and have weak sanitation and healthcare systems, but refugee families who live there deserve access to medicine and care if they become sick too. We work with governments to make sure they are included in national and local plans to address the COVID-19 pandemic. UNHCR has experience in dealing with virus outbreaks and global emergencies like SARS, Ebola, and influenza. Together with partners, we have started increasing distribution of clean water, soap, and waste disposal measures and launched information campaigns. We also work with countries hosting refugees to ensure they are included in plans to prepare and respond to the pandemic. But these countries also need support. International solidarity will be key if we're going to beat this virus. Everyone deserves to be protected from the coronavirus. Will people fleeing war still be able to cross borders? Countries can adopt measures to help control COVID-19, but they should not prevent people who may be fleeing from war from getting to safety. If there is a health risk, other actions can be taken, like testing or a time-limited quarantine. Could refugees become targets of discrimination? When fear and uncertainty kick in, scapegoats are never far away. We have already seen anger and hostility directed at some people. We have seen rumors circulating on social media. If left unchecked, the urge to blame and exclude may soon extend to other groups, minorities, the marginalized, and anyone labeled foreigner. COVID-19 does not discriminate. Why would you? Tourists, business people, and ministers have already been infected. COVID-19 is a test, not only of our healthcare systems and mechanisms for responding to infectious diseases, but also of our ability to work together as a community of nations in the face of a common challenge. Let's stay safe, smart, and kind.